originally part of Springfield. The land was purchased by John Pynchon in 1630. He purchased the land from the Agawam Indians. He wanted the muskrat and beaver pelts from the local animals. They were some of the only creatures with waterproof skin. The pelts were popular at this time and were used in wide-brim hats and boots. Eventually, many people settled here. The area of Longmeadow and East Longmeadow were wide fields as grazing areas for local animals. In the early 1700s, Longmeadow separated from Springfield. The population increased in the area of Longmeadow. The people started spreading out, and the land and people became known as two groups even though they were in one town. The East Village would eventually split and be known as East Longmeadow. The West Village would be the part that would be Longmeadow. They were also nicknamed the Street because they were in the section of town closest to Longmeadow Street, which was a major connecting road. The town needed more things as the population continued to grow. More people settled in the East Village to work in the quarries. Hundreds of immigrants swarmed the area for a job in the quarry. At town meetings, the people would vote which area received the new schools, meeting houses, etc. The East Side always got what they wanted because they had more people to swing the vote their way. Over years, the people in the West Village got increasingly angry over the East Village getting everything. The West Village also paid half the total town taxes, even though the East Village had more people and bigger businesses like quarries that made more money. At one point, there were about 1,600 people in the East Village and only 570 in the West Village, yet both sides were paying equal taxes, which was unfair. The West Side wanted to split from the East Village. They tried multiple times, and eventually the governor agreed and signed the bill for separation on May 22, 1894. The following July 4th, Longmeadow had a celebration for their separation. They only invited two people from East Longmeadow because those two people supported Longmeadow's side of the election.
The area was referred to as Longmeadow because it was a long meadow for cattle. The cattle could graze and explore the largely flat area. We are east of Longmeadow because we are located east of Longmeadow.
The East Longmeadow quarries opened in the 1800s and remained open until the early 1900s. They reopened from 1965 to 1971.
There were 50 plus quarries in town at one time.
What kind of stone did they quarry?
Sandstone varies in color from brown to red depending on how much iron was in the stone. The iron minerals would rest and turn the rock a redder color. The redder the stone, the more iron it had. The sandstone is located beneath the earth's surface and was created thousands of years ago when a giant glacier sat in the Pioneer Valley and deposited layers of sediment over time. The quarries were located all over town. Some of the most famous quarries were Redstone, Norcross, and Kibby.
How did they harvest and cut the stone?
Number one, the quarry men would locate large areas of rock and they would chisel by hand and used dynamite for the larger blasting projects. Number two, once they had a large stone, they used a jig crane to pick it up. They made sure no one was under it so they wouldn't get crushed. Number three, they would put it on a cart and bring it to the mill. Number four, a machine with iron blades propelled by a hand crank operated by eight men would cut the large blocks. Number five, to polish the stones, they used a circular machine to rub the punks of stone against each other and a wooden beam. Water was used to rinse the dust away. Six, they used a planer to give the stone straight sides. Number 7, a crane moved the pieces to a train where they were shipped around the world.
Railroad. The East Longmeadow Railroad used to be the Longmeadow Railroad, and it connected Springfield, Hartford, and New York. It was called the Connecticut Central Railroad. It was built in 1875. It helped move East Longmeadow's most valuable resource, brownstone, redstone, in and out of New England. Eventually, as the quarries closed, there was no longer a need for the railroad. In 2014, the town converted into the rail trail, a bike and walking trail. The original train house is still on it. Oh. Rotary. The East Longmeadow Rotary is in Ripley's, believe it or not, for being the only intersection without any lights. 7 streets come together at the Rotary. They are Prospect, Shaker, Elm, Pleasant, Maple, and Summers. The land was donated by Captain Taylor in 1864. There used to be a water fountain in the center of the Rotary for oxen and horses. This was before the invention of cars. In the front of the town hall, there is a similar water fountain and water pump that pays tribute to it. You can see the old water fountain.
At the East Longmeadow Rotary, by William L. Spite. 7 streets all at once there be, coming together you will see, with only 5 stop signs. Cars can't make up their minds at the East Longmeadow Rotary. Elm, Pleasant, and Summers make 3, with 4 more to cross for thee. Prospect, Shaker, Maple, and Main, discourtesy will drive you insane at the East Longmeadow Rotary. Not just a circle you'll see, several islands and signs are the key. Proceed with caution and pride, but ask the Almighty to be on your side at the East Longmeadow Rotary. To visit her niece came a lady from Lee. She entered not knowing where she be. Now where you're going, our horns will be blowing at the East Longmeadow Rotary. World famous for difficulty, we know o'er land and sea. Old folks often told fortune rides with the bold at the East Longmeadow Rotary. How some streets in town got their names. Brownstone Gardens, named for the stone which made the town famous, located on a former quarry, Glen Farms Drive. In 1894, this land was owned by Michael A. Glenn, who was one of the two town residents who favored separation from the West Village. His son, Leo D. Glenn, became a selectman and resided during the summers in the area, gardening and raising strawberries. Hampton Road. In 1894 and 1912, this was the name given to the street for its entire length from the center of town to the Hampton Town line. There were no connection with the original name of Allen Street. Kibbe Road. In 1831, Luke Kibbe and his son Luke Kibbe Jr. were owners of the quarries in the area. Lee Lee. In 1912, the street was called the New Road, although the name West Street did appear on the 1894 map, Markham Road, for the family who farmed in the area, Pease Road. Known early as Hall Hill Crossroad from Shaker Road to Baptist Village, the Pease family occupied the old homestead at 191 Pease Road from the early 1800s. Rankin Avenue. Mr. and Mrs. James Rankin, who donated the fence which surrounds the Green Law Cemetery.
Famous people in East Longmeadow. Asher Markham was born in Fulton, New York, April 20th, 1846, a son of Alden and Catherine Markham. His father was native of Schoharie County, New York, and came to East Longmeadow in 1864. Dr. Waterman was a town hero, and he entered the U.S. Air Force in 1970 while at the University of Vermont, and later completed his internship and residency at the Air Force's largest medical center, Wilford Hall USAF Medical Center in San Antonio, Texas. Leo M. Spate was born in 1901 and died in 1990. Also, Leo served on the Appropriation Committee from 1937 to 1957. Many people claim that Spate built the town. He became building homes with his brother Edward B. Spate in the 1920s, following in the footsteps of their father Edward J. Spate.
Mervyn H. Pease was born on January 22, 1860 in East Longmeadow. Pease was educated in town schools and Wesleyan Academy, after which he learned the shoemaking trade. James H. Rankin was born in Scotland December 16, 1860. He came to America in 1882, settling in Albany, and in 1890 came to East Longmeadow and started his quarrying and stone-cutting business, making a specialty of the Longmeadow sandstone, which he shipped to all parts of the United States. He donated the stone and fence for the cemetery near the Rotary of Pleasant Street. Clarence B. Cooley was born in East Longmeadow on June 23, 1896. Cooley was the son of Charles L. and Clara Burton Cooley. He had one brother, Leon Everett Cooley, who also resided in East Longmeadow. His marriage on November 11, 1925 was to Ida Johnson. Norcross. Another large employer of stone cutters was the Norcross Brothers of Worcester, which purchased the McGregory Quarry in 1876. Later, they also owned the Taylor, Salisbury, Laird, Kibby, and Pine Kibby quarries. Finally, they also purchased the Maynard Quarry off Elm Street. In 1901, the title of the company became Norcross Brownstone.
Police Department. At the turn of the 20th century, the town was protected by two constables whose duties included investigating robberies and other crimes, posting the warrants of town meetings, and serving local papers. In 1922, a local police department was organized with Aim L. J. Letendre, appointed as the first chief. Until that time, Frank Woodward had been a one-man police force, but had no title other than patrolman. Letendre also served as a patrolman and had to use his own automobile to pursue lawbreakers during the Roaring Twenties. His reports show numerous arrests for operating illegal stills.
Fire Department. The first fire station built in 1923 at the rear of the town hall was a one-car garage with a tin roof. It was large enough to store a forest fire wagon equipped with tools that had been supplied by the state. The wagon was not motorized and had to be hitched to a truck owned by the town or the trucks owned by the town, owned by either Ralph Kendall or Lewis Whitetaker, the owner of the local green store. In the same year, the town voted to purchase rubber coats and boots for the firemen. Also in 1923, a fire siren was installed in the tower of the town hall where it is used when if needed.
There are a lot of old historic buildings in this town. But what about the churches? Some of the old historic churches are the East Longmeadow First Congregational Church, the Longmeadow First Congregational Church, and the Baptist Village Church. Some more churches are the St. Paul Lutheran Church and the East Longmeadow Methodist Church. The East Longmeadow First Congregational Church was built from the idea of the Longmeadow First Congregational Church being built. The East Longmeadow First Congregational Church was established in 1827 and built in 1828. It got moved from Somers Road in 1859 to its present location in the Rotary. The property in front of the church, including the evergreen tree, was given to the church as long as it was used for the public and would always remain a public space. The Methodist Church was built in 1853 and torn down in 1968 through 1969.
One of the historic homes in East Longmeadow, 272 Kibbe Road, it was built in 1895. Hamden Road, it was built in 1852. Somersville Road, it was built in 1863. 116 Meadowbrook Road, it was built in 1866. 164 Parker Street, it was built in 1820. 22 Elm Street, it was built in 1890. 232 Prospect Street, it was built in 1792. 232 Prospect Street. A unique feature of the home is the second floor, which was originally the 4th District Schoolhouse, once located at North Main Street and Westwood Avenue. Records show that one-room school was completed in 1792, but moved to its present location in 1869. Hauled to the new location, it was raised on gunstock posts to become the second floor, and the first story was constructed to give the room some height. They added a slope. History about 56 Somersville. This house was in the family since ancestors purchased it in 1863. History about 116 Meadowbrook Road. The house was built in 1866 by Lucy Pease Hills and was known for many years as the Hills House. Also, Lucy Pease is the daughter of Mervyn Pease, the owner of Pease Road. The Norcross House is located on 89 Maple Street. It was built in the 1880s by the Norcross brothers who ran major quarries in town.
One historic building in town, the oldest house in East Longmeadow, is the Elijah Burt House. 1720, Elijah Burt lived in the house and passed it on to Ebenezer Burt, who lived in the house in 1831. In 1855, R. Stebbins lived in the house and passed it to R. R. Stebbins in 1870. 1894, Joseph Nichols lived in the house and passed it on to Jas Nichols in 1912. 1994, T.S. Bergamini lived in this house. The Underground Railroad wasn't really a railroad. It was a secret way from the South in slavery to the North in freedom. A lot of people would walk. Others would ride on a railway, a real one, or slaves hidden in a horse-drawn cart or carriage. How many people traveled on the Underground Railroad? That information was never kept. This was not recorded, so people would not get caught. Ebenezer Burt was probably the one who smuggled slaves. We think this because he worked at the church and traveled to Springfield a lot and probably took the slaves with him to the next stop on the Underground Railroad. Originally, the stagecoach stop over the house had the old wide floorboards, paneled walls from floor to ceiling, ancient fireplaces, and also a secret stairway led to the room in a cellar said to have been used to hid runaways during the Civil War days.
Before East Longmeadow became a town, it was determined that a new town hall was needed. People voted at town meetings back then, and the majority always got their way. There were more people in the East Village than the West Village, so they voted. East Village won, and the new town hall was built in the East Village. The Norcross brothers gave the town redstone to build the town hall. It was first used in 1882 for a town meeting. Eventually, East Longmeadow and Longmeadow separated, and the new town hall belonged to East Longmeadow because it was on town property. East Longmeadow built a library in the 1950s and attached it to the historic redstone town hall. In 2003, the old library was torn down and the new one opened in its place on February 3, 2004. The library used some of the old library and it was attached to the historic town hall. It was the perfect blend of old and new.
Early schools. In 1792, the first one-room school house was built in town. It was relocated twice, now located on 232 Prospect Street. It is the second story of a private home. Other schools were built in the east section of Longmeadow Industry. One on Porter Road, one on Pease Road, and one in the center. Center School was built in 1890. Center School was originally located in the center of East Longmeadow. It was moved in 1882 when the Norcross Brownstone Company donated the stone for the new town hall to be built at the center. The school to Elm, then Somers Road, where it stood until it was destroyed by a fire in 1906. The school was closed in 1969 with the opening of the new Meadowbrook School. 2 years later, the selectmen determined that the building was a fire and safety hazard and in such poor condition that it would be too expensive to make repairs, and that if it were repaired, the town had no use for the space. On October 4th, 1976, town meeting vote brought the end to the proud old school, and it was demolished at a cost of $3,750. Pleasant View School. In 1960, $20,000 was approved for building Pleasant View School. In 1917, bids were accepted for construction of a septic system at the new school. In 1918, the school was already overcrowded. Also that year, the school was closed for 4 weeks due to a nationwide epidemic of influenza. By 1921, the 7th and 8th grade classes had to use the hallways for a classroom due to overcrowding. In 1923, double sessions had to be held. Finally, in 1924, four rooms and auditorium were added. This still didn't fix the problem. Double sessions continued. Teachers and students sponsored and apparatus to buy playground equipment and indoor and outdoor items to play with. In 1931, a stage was added, and the next year, a soup kitchen for hot lunches. The school closed in 1969 after many years of overcrowding and outdated classrooms and facilities.
Bertram Park Middle School. The new school cost $78.4 million and East Longmeadow paid $44 million and the state paid for the rest. The old Birchland was built in 1951 and the new one was built in 2003. It is on 50 Hanward Hill. Birchland's principal is Tim Allen. Birchland's grades contain 6 through 8. The test results are learning more about school performances.
Birchland School was built in 1954. There are 16 classrooms. The main lobby allows people to use public areas like the gym at night without entering the classroom areas. The cafeteria and auditorium take full advantage of sunlight.
Mountain View School was built in 1960. It was designed to be cost efficient. All classrooms were designed with a door to the outside or less traffic in the hallway. It also made it safer in case of a fire. The land has 18.41 acres between Hampton and Summers Road, and there are 20 classrooms.
Meadowbrook Elementary School opened on February 24, 1969. K-5 students began to attend in September 1969. The building was designed to hold 600 to 700 students. The new school had air conditioning and fully carpeted, which was amazing for the time.
The town wanted their high school students to be taught in town and no longer have to worry about making trips to Springfield every day. The Springfield superintendent also said the Springfield schools would no longer accept out-of-town students after 1962. So they decided to build a high school in East Longmeadow after the new middle school. They chose 20 different possible locations, but ultimately put the school on Maple Street. It cost $2,170,000 to build and to build an extra $130,000 for an indoor swimming pool.
East Longmeadow Spartans logo. They had a contest at East Longmeadow High School in 1960 to pick a logo. They wanted something easy to copy on uniforms, pens, and school newspapers. The winner was announced in a school-wide assembly. It was a picture of a Spartan in profile drawn by Phil Demetrian.
A summary of what we learned. 1630, a Puritan migration of England to North America. First settlers of Springfield came from the Boston area, led by William Pynchon from Roxbury. 1636, Agawam plantation purchased from the Agawam Indians and founded by William Pynchon. 1641, Agawam
Plantation was remained Springfield after Pynchon's home in England. 1645, common land in New England, in the Longmeadow was divided in individually owned farm lots. 1675, the great Indian uprising known as King Philip's War began. 1714, they started building in Longmeadow Green. 1744, beginning the French and Indian War, Longmeadow men engaged the battle. 1750, first house were built around East Village or Parish in East Village. 1775, April 21st, Longmeadow farmers joined Springfield Minutemen Company to assist at Lexington and Concord. American Revolution.
Longmeadow was 1783. Longmeadow was established as an independent town split from Springfield. 1819. Major typhus epidemic resulting in many child and adult deaths. 1844. A Hartford to Springfield Railroad was completed. The station in the Meadows was opened until the early 20th century. 1850. Total Longmeadow population had reached 1,250. The East Village is 750. The West Village, now Longmeadow, is 500. 1894. Longmeadow was split into two towns, Longmeadow, the West Village, with 570 people, and East Longmeadow, the East Village, with 1,613 people.
1890, Stonecutter Strike. 1896, the first public library was created in East Longmeadow. 1902, electric trolleys were set up in East Longmeadow that allowed for transportation around town. 1922, police station strike started. 1923, the fire station was established. 1951, the old Bertram Park School opened. 1954, Maple Shade School opened.